guys are a hard act to follow. Dave kind of stole all my stuff here.
Hello. You should have talked first.
Well, Glenn and I started back when I was editor for the Lodge newsletter. I hadn't met him yet, but I was getting all these emails from him that had bits and pieces, different quotes, and you know, a lot of Masonic quotes from some Masonic sources and some not so Masonic quotes. And one month I was getting close to the deadline, like I do, like I had been every month. I had a little space to fill in a newsletter, so I just grabbed something that fit really well in there out of one of Glenn's emails, and it fit perfectly, but it turns out it was one of those not-so-Masonic quotes, and we had to end up apologizing. Turns out a new newsletter and apologizing for it. But shortly thereafter, he turned up in the lodge, and that was the first time I met him face to face. And he came up and introduced himself as my partner in crime. So after that, we were communicating quite a bit, and I discovered just how involved in masonry he was. It was 24/7, you know, with his visits to other lodges and dependent bodies, and his studies of Masonic history. And volunteering. And he got us involved with Feed My Starving Children. And several of us went to pack meals, and I thought, this is great. This is what I want to do when I'm sitting in the East, is get people out to do this. So when I was getting close to that position, I started searching online for volunteering opportunities. And I came across Simon Says, and I kind of looked through it real quick, and I immediately told Glenn about it. By the next day, he had it under control. He took the bull by the horns, and we were already scheduled to start volunteering there. And he made my job pretty easy. But by the following year, he was named official ambassador to Simon Says. And due to his calling to other organizations, he was able to persuade them to even contribute even more money. And some folks here from Simon Says will tell you a little bit more about that. Last year, they gave us 150 backpacks for our own distribution. And his studies in Masonic history has earned him the position of lodge historian. While it's not an official position, he's installed every year with the rest of the officers. And we all come up with our own installation sayings for him, and he has a jewel for it. And his writings can be found on Facebook and in a lot of our newsletters. And I could go on and on, but some folks have some other things to say. So, with that, I'll say keep smiling, and God bless.